students, can you hear me?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so what is a computer hardware? Means what computer is? Computer system is made up of many components or parts like keyboard, mouse, speakers, monitor, camera. All are the computer parts which are connected together with computer system. Okay, each component performs special task. Means mouse be used for clicking, keyboard is used for typing, and in monitor we can see any work which we are doing. Okay, and from speakers you are getting voice, and from web camera you are doing video chatting, and you are doing now online classes also, no? And in CPU the data or any information stored in CPU. Means what? In CPU, if you do any drawing on a computer, then it can store in a CPU. Where it will get stored? Your information, where it will get stored? In CPU. Yes, in CPU your information will get stored. So there are
CPU.
Yes, right. And hardware means what exactly? Which you can see. Means keyboard you can see, no? And touch also. Mouse also you can see. And you can touch also for mouse. Monitor also you can see. But you can't see what is inside the computer. Means what? Which are present outside the computers, like keyboard, CPU, mouse, speakers, web camera, are all of the called hardware. What it is called?
Hardware.
So there are some different components of computer system, and computer system can be divided into 3 categories. Means input device, output device, and component inside the CPU box. Means input device is different, output device is different, and component inside the CPU box. Means in CPU box there are some components that we will study in next class, but today we will discuss about the, once again, input devices. Okay, so see here, computer hardware means what exactly? You read this, all of you. Can you see this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, read. A computer system.
Yes, ma'am.
Computer system,
yes, ma'am,
is made up of many components or parts. Components or parts mean keyboard, mouse, speakers, all these. And inside CPU, what it is there? All the components are parts. All are connected together and work together to computer system. Each components perform a special task. Means keyboard is used for typing like this. All component performs special task, and all the computer components work together to operate a computer system. Okay, all of you got it?
Yes, ma'am.
You have any doubt?
No, ma'am.
So see this next. Data and instruction. What is the input device? See here. What is the input device? Input device. Data and instructions must be entered into computer system in order to carry out various tasks. Means what? Suppose if you want to do any calculations on computer, so what you are use? A calculator, and you type from keyboard. Yeah, you type from keyboard, like 2 plus 2 if you want to add, then you are putting the instructions and data to the computer. You are entering the data and instructions to the computer by keyboard in computer. In order to carry various tasks, means you have to calculate the addition. Okay, and mouse means what? You are mouse for using the selecting the options. Okay, and what the use of scanner?
Scanner
is different. The scanner means you have to copy the documents. To copy documents, you use scanners. So next one is joystick. See joysticks image, and this image, blue image, is your video game remote, and red one is a joystick. You all of you know, no? Video games, you play video games.
Have a remote control.
Yes, remote is there, and there are some buttons over there to operate all your games. Left keys are there, left, right.
Yes, ma'am.
Likewise, in red joystick also buttons are there. See all of you. You can see that black buttons up area.
Yes, ma'am.
Can you see this?
Yes,
down that round area also some buttons are there. See. By using that button, you operate joystick, and joystick is an input device. Because you are putting some information through joystick on computer. Did you get this?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, so what is the use of joystick? Joystick is an input device. Joystick is used to change the position of the cursor or any other object on the screen. Means if any you want to change the position on cursor, then joystick can use. Like if you want to change the cursor to the left side, then left button you can use. If you want to change the position to the right, then right side button you can use. And object on the screen means any object on the screen means what? If you want any object is there on your monitor or any screen, then you can change that object. Where you want, left side or right side or up area or down area. Joystick used for playing video games. You play games now like car racing or gun, any means of missions, like all of you know the games?
Yes, ma'am.
Which games you are playing?
Yes,
on computer or on mobile?
Ma'am,
So joystick is used to move any object to left side or right side, up area, anywhere you want. Okay, so next one is
light pen.
See here, image. Some tablet like this, and light pen is just like a light pen. What?
Mama, I have tablet.
Okay, light pen means what? It's just like a pen, but it contains any sensors over there. So you can write directly on your tablet, or you can select anything directly on your tablet. Like a pen. How you write on your paper or in your notebook, no? Your pencil or pen. Likewise, here directly you can write on your tablet through light pen. Light pen is also a input device. It is shaped like a pen. A light pen connected to the VDU. VDU stands for Visual Display Unit. Means what? Here you can see that blue images means like that screen.
Yes, ma'am.
A desk name is visual display area, that is. You can directly write down there or select anything you want. Next one is draw or point two objects on the computer screen. Means you can draw anything on your computer screen or point anything on your computer screen. Next is
microphone.
Microphone. Microphone.
Ma'am, sound. Record or sound line.
Yes, right. Microphone. See how it looks like. Microphone is also an input device. Okay. See here, microphone is used to input sound into a computer. Means any microphone is there, then you are inputting your voice on computer or you are recording any voice on your computer. Now I am talking, then you can hear it, you know?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes,
yes, ma'am.
Yes, because there are some microphones there, because you can hear me. And some sound also we can record on microphone. Like any classes, if you want to record and you can hear afterwards, then the microphone we use. And any speeches are there for any functions at school, colleges, the microphones are there. You see on stage there is microphone set. All of you know?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. It helps in recording your voice. Microphone helps us to record your voice. Next one is
graphic tablet.
See the image. See the image. It also looks like a tablet only, but it is a different. It is a graphic tablet, and there is also a pen, but it is called as a stylus. What it is called? Black pen is there, and see in the hand. In the hand, that is called as stylus. That is only used for graphic tablet. What? That is only used for graphic tablet. That pen is only for graphic tablet. All of you see the image?
Yes.
Some drawings are there. See, some options are there, right side in black.
Yes, ma'am.
And
yes, ma'am.
So graphic tablet is an input device. Okay, graphic tablet is an input device. It is used to draw images and pictures on the computer screens. See here, the images and pictures, they are drawn by that stylus. You can draw just like how you can draw in your book, your notebook, like by pen or pencil. Okay, you can draw just like pen on graphic tablet. Graphic tablets used for capturing the handwritten signature of people. If you want to take anyone of signature or a handwritten signature directly by that stylus, handwritten signature we can do on that graphic tablet. All of you got it?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Any doubt? Yeah.
No, ma'am.
What?
No, ma'am.
No, ma'am.
Okay,
no, ma'am.
What it is?
Barcode reader
means that black device is there in hand. It is called as a barcode reader.
Barcode reader.
Stop making voice now. That black device is there in hand. It is called as barcode reader. And which are the thick lines here, you know, and number below that lines. You can see this image.
Never textbook bag.
What?
Textbook bags are also there.
Yes, in textbook bags are also is there. I showed you know, in last class textbook backside also is there, and there is lines are there that is called as barcode, and which machine is there in your hand, it is called as barcode reader. Barcode reader is also a input device. It is used to read barcodes, means it is used to read the barcode. If you put that machine in front of that barcode, then it can take that number and that lines, and it operate on directly on the computer. A barcode is a pattern printed in lines of different thickness that can be seen on many products. Means you can see any products in supermarkets, DMarts you have gone, no?
Yes, ma'am.
You can see there in near billing counter.
Yes, ma'am.
There is machine. If any product.
Yes, ma'am.
If any product.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, it is.
Yes, they are directly take that device in front of your product and directly that product price goes on there. Machine and they are calculating it. Okay, and the other barcode reader we can use in many ways. A barcode reader interprets these lines to input the information of product into the computer systems. Means in that barcode reader some information is there about that product, means like price, that product number, and that can read by that machine and directly save in computer. Okay, barcodes are widely used in supermarkets and recording sale for items of weekly. What is this?
Touch screen.
Yes.
Touch screen.
All of you have a touch screen. You have using your mobile there. You can touch anything. Then you can open that option anywhere you want. And
I'm in car also.
Like yes, right. In car also there is option, and tablet also there is touch screen. You can directly touch an option which you want to open that option. Siri is off touch screen. A touch screen is a touch sensitive computer display screen. Display screen means what? Which you can see that screen and directly you can touch to that, and some sensitive area is there, so directly that option open. Next one, touch screen are often found in public places such as ATMs, ticket terminals and airports, where we use the touch screen options in ATMs. You have seen or anyone going to ATMs
the machine
to withdraw. Yes, to ATM some options are there. You have to put your number and which amount or what amount you want to withdraw. Then you have to select that all options by touch screen only. And ticket terminals which are there in airports and railway stations, there is also a we use touch screen devices. Okay, this is also an input device. All of you got it?
Yes,
right.
Yes.
Next one is MICR. Last class also I told MI about CR, no? See how it, here is some white machine is there, and that blue, what it is, say MICR, that is a check. And below in textbook also you can see on page number 4 there is a check and below there is a some number is there.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, number is there. And MICR stands for magnetic ink character recognition. It is a special type of device used for processing checks in banks. Means the checks are processed in that machine and it is used in banks. The number codes at the bottom of the checks are written using special ink called magnetic ink. Means what? The numbers which are below there in check. You can see that image on the textbook.
Yes, ma'am.
The number is there. Then by that number, number, the special link is there. So, and it is called as a magnetic ink. So that check can directly read on that machine how which amount or which whose that check is there. The next one, MICRs are used to read these characters. Next one is.
And digital camera.
Yes.
And digital camera.
Digital camera is digital there.
Digital camera.
Yes, digital camera. All of you need digital camera, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Camera. Camera to capture images. And some cameras will record videos also. In mobile also,
camera.
Yes. And in mobile also, there is camera.
Camera.
Laptop also a camera.
Ma'am, laptop.
Yes. Digital camera also an input device because it can take our images or we can capture images and we can save it on a computer. Okay, so it is also an input device. And pictures taken using digital camera are stored on the memory card. Inside the digital camera, there is some memory card like in black in color, and that our all images which we have captured all are stored in that memory card. And there is some cable is also there, like wire. We can connect that to the camera to PC and we can see the images in computer also which we are captured. All of you know that?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes. Next one is web camera. Have you seen this web camera anywhere?
Yes.
Where?
Yes, ma'am.
Camera is for recording videos and for video chatting. Yes, video chatting, video calling. In mobile also there is cameras, but this is a web camera which are different. Means it is connected to the desktop computer, and in laptop there is inbuilt camera. Means there is inside only a camera, but this web camera is different. It is a separate device which we have to connect by wire.
Camera record.
No,
sir. Web camera. I mean, it is Bluetooth wire.
What? It is a. It has a wire which we have to connect to the CPU. Then we can see the. We can see. Videos means video. We can use for it is video calling and video chatting, video chatting. And now we are taking online classes now. So you can see me by this web camera only. You can see me, but because we are using here desktop. But in laptop, inbuilt camera is there. No need.
Laptop.
Yes, there is a inbuilt camera means. Inside only a camera is there in laptop. No need to take like this, like black device, like this web camera, separate device for this.
Okay. CCTV can also record that.
Yes, record all what it is. Yes. A web camera records video that can be saved, viewed, or sent on other people using the internet. Means through internet, web camera we can record videos and saved, viewed, and sent to the other people. CCTVs you have seen, no, all of you?
Yes, ma'am, and computer
also is
there. Yes, ma'am,
all over the yes, CCTVs are there. We can see this and all which are happening, all that videos are saved. And we can see afterwards also that videos. And we can save that computer also. And it is used for video chatting also. Next one is biometric device. This is also a input device. Okay? All of you see?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am.
So where we use
biometric device? Banks.
And for security purpose also these biometric devices are using in banks or any everywhere biometric devices are used for security purpose. There are passwords are there and they are saved inside there, and by your fingertips or you can directly put your finger on that machine and that can scan and detect that person whose fingerprints is there, and that already saved that your fingerprints details on that machine. So when you put on that machine, your fingerprints are scanned and detect your information. This device used for identification and access control means which person is there that is identified by that fingerprints. They helps for enhancing the security as compared to the system of login IDs and password. Means they are saved login IDs and passwords are there. Different IDs and passwords for different peoples. Okay, all of you got that input devices?
Yes.
You have any doubt? You have any doubt about any input devices?
No, ma'am.
Which are the input devices? So next one is what? Output device. Output device means what? Output device means where you can get the results after inputting any information or data. Means suppose you have entered any numbers or letters on keyboard or by keyboard, then what you are getting from that screen, whatever you are typing on that letters or numbers on the screen, you can see on that screen. Suppose you entered your name on keyboard, where you have seen that your name, where you can see,
ma'am,
if you entered your name on keyboard, then you can see that on your screen, no, monitor,
computer,
your monitor, what it is called, monitor, you see on the screen, no? You can see that on, where you can see on
monitor.
Okay, and when you inputting your voice, where you get voice from,
speakers
or some poems or some videos are there in your computer, then where you get voice from,
I mean speaker.
Yes, by speakers you get voice. When you get result or any instructions from computer, it is called the output device. Means whatever data or any information you are getting from computer, that is a output. Means it is a readable form. Means whatever you inputting to the computer, means whatever the information you are giving to the computer gives is in a result form. So it means in like whatever you seen in your monitor and you are getting voice from speaker, that is a output devices. You are getting output from that. Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
Monitor is output device, speaker is output device, and printer is also output device. Why printer is output device? Because suppose if you want to take any print of images or any picture from computer, any image is there. Yes. Suppose if you want to take a picture of your drawing which you have drawn on a computer, then you want a print from that, then where you are going? You are getting that from printer. So printer is giving you a picture in picture from printer. So printer is a output device. Okay, because he is giving you the images which you are drawn on a computer. Got it? So
yes, ma'am.
From tomorrow class we'll discuss about what are all the output device like printers. We'll discuss about the printers in tomorrow's class. Okay?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, students. Bye. Any doubt is there? Any doubt is there?